Greetings Guardians, my name is Bife here. So, a few things before we start. I want to let you know that it's time for some experimental content on the channel. This week, stay tuned for what some of you may see as a complete departure from what I typically do here, and what was for me one of the most entertaining pieces of content I've ever created with Dan John and my other moderators. Finally, let me know what you think of the footage in the background, and also do know that the audio recording for this is going to be a little bit different. There is a good reason behind that. The reason being that my new microphone decided that, effectively, it was going to go die in a fire before it had even been used. So I'm running on a completely different recording setup, which involves an iPad of all things. So if the audio on this one is a bit weird, that is entirely why. We will see what we can do about getting through this next one. I'll be able to fix that in future videos, but for the moment, we're just gonna have to make do. So if this sounds a little bit off or a little bit lower par than usual, my sincerest apologies for that. I understand that quality is something you guys expect in these videos. Anyway, enough waffle. Today is one of those days where we're going to be talking about some lore that is deeply theoretical, and we're going to use it to try and answer one of your questions. This one was so commonly asked back in the days before the Curse of Osiris released that I was called upon in multiple Reddit threads to consult on the matter. The question was this. In the lore, Osiris is regularly referred to as a Sunsinger, yet in the trailer we see him using the Dawnblade super. Why is this? Some wider questions on the matter asked whether this had something to do with Dominus Gaul tapping the light from the Traveler, and whether Osiris had learned the technique after the Red War and his own light might have been diminished. And whilst it's a very good question, I'm actually going to defer it to a later video because, for starters, I don't know if it's relevant, seeing as, from all of the conversation that he's indicated, Osiris seems completely unfazed or even at points unaware of the Red War. And also, I really don't think that we have the adequate information that we might need to answer this question at the moment. However, it is still very important, and we will get to answer it if we do indeed get enough information to do so. I do fully intend to cover this topic. Anyway, I should preface all of this by saying that this area of lore that we're about to jump into is more specifically going to talk about how light functions. And as I said earlier, this is not a 100% concrete area of the lore. A lot of it is very much implied through the lore and gameplay mechanics, but I can't find any one place that would concretely confirm my theory, so I will once again say, my postulation in this video is just that. It is me wondering what the answer to this question is. Now, in the process of answering this question, you could quite simply just slap an easy answer onto it and say, because video game, or because marketing, and call it a day. And I do that with some things in Destiny because I think that's all they are. But in this instance, I think that you can come up with a better answer for this particular question. In short, it appears that there's evidence that Destiny 2's new supers were in fact not new, that they were a part of the universe all along. The Arcstrider super has a lore tab that makes note of this and reads as follows. No one remembers who the first Arcstrider was. Hardly anyone remembers the Arcstriders at all. Time vanished us like it does memories. But in the darkest days of the Dark Age, when humanity was utterly defenseless, Arcstriders disciplined their bodies to let the Traveler's energy flow through them, to call lightning itself to hand and wield it like a staff against darkness. If the Arcstriders therefore were present during the Dark Ages, then that means that they were amongst some of the first Guardians ever to exist. In other words, they're not new at all. The super may have been forgotten and only just rediscovered, but the practice itself of being an Arcstrider, of using arc energy as a hunter in this particular fashion, is most certainly not new. So this quote shows us that technically some of the supers from Destiny 2 might not be new at all. However, a bigger point is raised at the end of this quote, which is that Arcstriders learned to wield the Traveler's energy like a staff. This implies that the energy of the Traveler can be harnessed to be used in other ways, as appears to be clear from the differences between the old Arcblade and the new Arcstrider. Even more important is the Ward of Dawn that is castable by both Defender and Sentinel Titans. which is further proof of the fact that light isn't something as rigid as it will seem from the gameplay mechanics. I think that we have supers that are set for the sake of the gameplay and balance, but in the lore, harnessing light is a talent that can have many forms of success. Light, perhaps for the purposes of the canon universe, appears as though it can be used in a multitude of ways. It just needs to be learned and eventually mastered. And perhaps this is the major thing that sets people apart. Hence why, Sentinel Titans have the option to summon a less powerful Ward of Dawn or to use the more aggressive Sentinel Shield, whilst to Defender Titans will only ever be able to summon the Ward of Dawn, but its practical use is something completely distinct and has many functions from the typical Titan bubble that a Sentinel might summon. Both forms of the Ward of Dawn harness the entropy of void light that powers all void supers, just as it powers a Nova Bomb or indeed the Sentinel Shield as standard, but both are dramatically different in terms of the technique used to summon such light. With this, we could apply the same logic to Sunsingers and Dawnblades. This is in fact only furthered by the point that most of our powers as a Dawnblade, such as our grenades and our melee traits, are shared by the former Sunsinger counterparts that we used in Destiny 1. Some of the key figures of Sunsingers and Dawnblades are in fact almost indistinguishable. Take for example the fact that Sunsingers grow 4 wings, whilst Dawnblades will grow only 2, but both classes have the ability to use perks that will allow them to summon these wings on demand and hover periodically mid-air. You can take a look at this in the Angel of Light perk from Destiny 1, or alternatively in the Attunement of Sky in Dawnblades during Destiny 2. Both perks have very similar notions and very similar uses, so it's not totally out of the question that the two are related in some sense, but I think that it all boils down to technique, and perhaps in the end, if we really condense it and simplify everything to the fundamentals, there are no Sunsingers and there are no Dawnblades. There is only solar light used by warlocks. If I were to sum it all up, I think it's just a problem that video game mechanics in this instance have with conveying the nature of Destiny's universe. In short, asking Osiris why he is using Dawnblade and not a Sunsinger is like asking one of us why we're using solar grenades over firebolts, or why we're using empowering rift over healing rift. In the end, the important thing to remember is that there is no grenade, perhaps, and there is no class ability, there is no melee, and there is not even a super. There is only the light, and the different ways in which you can learn to wield it. The only thing that separates them is perhaps their elemental focus being arc, void, or solar, and the techniques used to harness the energy of the light, be that a Dawnblade, a Sunsinger, an Arc Strider, or an Arc Blade, a Defender, or a Sentinel. And as a result, we can see that maybe Destiny's universe isn't so limited. If this is the case, then Sunsingers and Dawnblades aren't mutually exclusive, and it is conceivable, at very least, that we might see Sunsingers in the scenario once again. It appears Sunsingers and Dawnblades probably aren't mutually exclusive. A likely scenario appears to be that we might one day actually reclaim the power of becoming a Sunsinger, and if this is to happen, then I believe it will be dramatically changed from Destiny 1 for the sake of balance. But even so, questions should be asked on a somewhat important point. Do you think this will happen, and what do you think of this theory? Whilst I think it's much more likely by the fact that a Dawnblade is being used by Osiris, who is commonly seen in the lore, with no hyperbole, as one of the most powerful guardians to have ever existed, I do wonder, because again, we don't have any concrete theory on this. But keep in mind that all of this is something we may find out in time, and for the moment, I want all of your opinions on this. So tell me, what do you think of this idea? Do you think there are tidbits of lore that can verify this? Do you think that I've missed something? Do you have your own theory? If you do, let me know in the comments section down below. In the meantime, if you enjoyed this video, please feel free to leave a like, and of course, if you want more videos on Destiny's lore, then please hit the subscribe button and hit the bell next to subscribe to turn on email notifications. But of course, your viewership is quite enough for me. And in the meantime, my name has been My Name Is Bife. Perodacia Ad Astra. I'll see you, Starside.